In this extra part of the video, we will study one specific textbook in the series, to understand better the structure of the book unit. The textbook we'll choose to look at today is, English 3, the first book in the series. Note that the information from this video is summarized from the teacher's book of the series, so feel free to refer to this book, if you need more information. Let's start with an overview of the textbook first. This is the first level of the three-level English textbook series for Vietnamese primary school pupils, learning English as a foreign language. The series follows the syllabus approved by the Ministry of Education and Training in August 2010, and covers a systematic, technical and topic-based development of the basic English language skills, with emphasis on listening and speaking for early levels. Before we analyze the book, I'd like you to take out the student's book and study it first. Questions will appear on the screen, and you have around 1 minute to answer each question. These questions will help you to understand the book better. Are you ready? Let's start. Are you ready? Let's check your answers and learn about the textbook itself. The student's book follows a sequence of presentation, practice, and production to develop English at a basic level through 20 topic-based units and 4 reviews units, which are richly illustrated and cross-curricular to provide pupils with easy-to-grasp and memorable lessons and an enjoyable experience of learning English. Each unit consists of 3 lessons on a topic related to one of the 4 themes: me and my friends, me and my school, me and my family, aunt, me and the world around, all of which are designed to invoke a sense of familiarity. The activities are organized to provide training on listening, speaking, reading, as well as writing. Each lesson provides material for a 2 teaching period, equal to 70 minutes. The lesson contains concise and clear instructions for a wide range of activities, arranged in a logical progression, helping pupils to develop critical thinking, coordination, and the ability to interact with each other as they learn to understand and use English in both its spoken and written form. A variety of extra activities, including singing, chanting, TPR, or total physical response activities, exciting games, and a creative project at the end of each unit aim to facilitate the pupil's ability to reproduce language in a fun and engaging way. Okay, now let's turn to the unit structure. I have 2 questions for you to think about before we discuss them in detail. 1. How many lessons are there in a unit? 2. What are the parts in each unit? Feel free to look at the student's book to help you answer these questions. Have you finished? Now let's analyze these lessons together. Lesson 1. 1. Look, listen, and repeat. This section provides pupils with key vocabulary and structures in comic form. It focuses on reading, listening, and oral practice. 2. Point and say. This section provides controlled practice of key vocabulary and structures. Regarding the first pictures, pupils may do either choral or individual repetition of key vocabulary and structures using information in it. The second picture requires pair practice. Mechanical drills employed in both tasks are repetition, substitution, question and answer, and transformation to help pupils familiarize themselves with the key vocabulary and structures and thus can reproduce them in wider contexts. 3. Let's talk. This section provides free practice of key vocabulary and structures. Pupils are able to choose their language in 2 different situations, illustrated in the textbook. This task facilitates a vast amount of pair interaction. 4. Listen and tick. This section focuses on developing pupils' listening skills. In some units, there are 2 pairs of pictures. Pupils look at one pair at a time, listen to the recording, and choose the correct picture according to what they hear by putting a check in the corresponding box. In others, pupils number the pictures while listening. 5. Let's write. This section is presented in the form of a gap-filling exercise with textual and/or visual prompts. It helps pupils use the key vocabulary and structures they have learned. 6. Let's sing, chant, play. To help pupils fortify and or reproduce the key vocabulary and structures, a variety of activities including learning easy-to-learn songs and chants, playing games, writing about themselves are introduced in this section. The songs, chants and games enable pupils to practice pronunciation and rhythm of English through peer interaction and cooperation, while writing allows them to express themselves in simple sentences. Lesson 2. The initial three sections of this lesson, 1. Look, listen and repeat, 2. Point and say, and 3. Let's talk, follow the same pattern as in lesson 1. 4. Listen and number. This section is another activity focusing on developing pupils' listening skills. Pupils look at the pictures while they listen and number the boxes in the correct order or ticking true or false. 5. Read and complete. This section aims to give pupils a glimpse into reading at an early stage. Practice includes gap-filling exercises, matching texts with pictures, answering the questions, or choosing the correct answers. 6. Let's sing, write, play. Similar to its counterpart in Lesson 1, this section enables pupils to reproduce language through singing, playing games or writing, based on visual and or textual prompts. Lesson 3. 1. Listen and repeat. This section teaches the phonics appearing frequently in the vocabulary and structures of the unit, which young Vietnamese learners might find problematic. Pupils acclimatize themselves to the letters and sounds by listening and repeating. 2. Listen and write. In this section, pupils practice the phonics they have learned through a dictation task. Pupils listen and fill in the gaps. 3. Let's chant. This section contains a chant, which uses the structures pupils have learned in lessons 1 and 2. Like songs, chants are a helpful way of teaching the rhythm of English, which is very different from Vietnamese. 4. Read and match. This section asks pupils to read and match sentence halves or questions with the answers. 5. Read and write, complete. This section asks pupils to read and complete or write sentences. It practices the key vocabulary and or structures in the unit. 6. Project. In this section, pupils carry out a creative project individually or in groups. This activity is to foster cooperation and interaction among the class. And that's all about the structure of the book, as well as the structure of a unit in the book we are studying. I hope that will help you to understand the book better and get ready to make better use of it in your teaching. See you in the next module.